Where are you? Where is your mind? Is it inside your body? Probably in your head, somewhere behind the eyes, right? It is commonly believed that our experiences are produced by this big organ in our heads, called the brain. But recent scientific evidence suggests something else. We've known that most experiences correspond to certain patterns of brain activation. For instance, computers can scan your brain and correctly guess what you're looking at or even what you're imagining. When someone is looking at an object, say a tree, we can see specific parts of the brain light up. That's amazing. It must mean that the brain generates our experiences, right? Not quite. No one in the entire history of science has been able to explain how brain metabolism produces the richness of experience we commonly refer to as the mind. Perhaps it doesn't produce the mind at all. A new and vast body of evidence strongly suggests a completely different relationship between the brain and the mind. Here's the thing. Experiments show that certain reductions or impairments of normal brain activity correlate precisely with richer and intenser experience. Take drugs. Well, not literally. For decades, we thought that psychedelic substances worked by lighting up the brain like a Christmas tree. Since 2012, however, experiments in respected institutions like the University Hospital Zurich and the Imperial College London have shown that the opposite occurs. You could have the most mind-boggling experience of your life while your brain effectively goes to sleep. And the evidence doesn't stop at psychedelics. Vietnam War veterans that had suffered brain injury were more likely to report rich spiritual experiences. Pilots undergoing acceleration-induced loss of consciousness, which drains blood out of the brain, report having rich dreams while seemingly unconscious. People who recover from a near-death experience regularly describe extremely rich, even life-changing sensations, even though medical experts know that shortly after cardiac arrest, there's almost no brain activity. Some people practicing meditation achieve rich, trance-like states by using hyperventilation techniques that reduce brain metabolism. The list goes on. How is this possible? While it is undeniable that the brain and the mind are closely related, perhaps we need to fundamentally rethink what that relationship really is. Maybe the brain is not the generator of consciousness, but merely the image of a particular state of consciousness, less like a factory and more like a river. This alternative way of thinking may be hard to grasp, but it will determine the future, not only of science and philosophy, but of our very way of life. Anyway, that's where we are. Where's your mind at?